Pardon me for asking, but who's that little old man?
What little old man?
That little old man.
Oh, that one, that's my grandfather.
Your grandfather?
Yeah.
That's not your grandfather.
It is, you know.
But I've seen your grandfather, he lives in your house.
Oh, that's my other grandfather, but he's my grandfather as well.
How do you reckon that one out?
Well, everyone's entitled to two, aren't they? And it's my other one.
We know that, but what's he doing here?
Well, my mother thought the trip would do him good.
How's that?
He's nursing a broken heart.
Ah, poor old thing. Hey, mister, are you nursing a broken heart? He's a nice old man, isn't he?
He's very clean.
Hello, grandfather.
Hello.
He can talk then, can he?
Of course he can talk. He's a human being, isn't he?
Well, if he's your grandfather, who knows?
And we're looking after him, are we?
I look after myself.
Yeah, that's what I'm afraid of.
He's got you worried, then.
Him? He's a villain. A real mixer. And it cost you a fortune in breach of promise cases.
Get on.
No, straight up.
I am.
Hello, Sheikh.
Hello, Sheikh.
You got on all right, then?
No.
Oh. Well, we're here. Norm will be along in a minute with the tickets. Hey, who's the little old man?
It's Paul's grandfather.
Oh, aye, but I thought...
No, that's his other one.
Oh, that's all right, then.
Clean, though, isn't he?
Oh, aye, he's very clean.
Morning, lads.
Hi, Norm.
Morning, Norm. How's it going?
Thank God you've all got here. Now, look, I've had a marvellous idea. Just for once, let's all try to behave like ordinary, respectable citizens. Let's not cause any trouble, pull any strokes, or do anything I'm going to be sorry for. Especially tomorrow in that television theatre. Because... Are you listening to me, Lennon?
You're a swine, isn't he, George? You're a swine.
Thanks. Hey!
Who's that little old man?
Well, who is he?
He belongs to Paul.
Oh, well. I'm going down for a cup of coffee. Anyone coming?
We'll follow you down.
I want me coffee.
Well, you can come with Sheikh and me if you like.
Look after him. I don't want to find you've lost him.
Don't be cheeky. I'll bind him to me with promises. Very clean, isn't he? Come on, Grandad.
Make up your mind, will you?
Mind if we have it open?
Yes, I do.
Yeah, but there are four of us and we'd like it open. If it's all the same to you, that is.
It isn't. I travel on this train regularly, twice a week. So I suppose I've some rights.
So have we.
Then we'll have that thing off as well, thank you. Well, an elementary knowledge of the Railway Act would tell you that I'm perfectly within my rights.
Yeah, but we want to hear it.
There's more of us than you. We're a community, a majority vote, up the workers and all that stuff.
Then I suggest you take that damn thing into the corridor. Or some other part of the train. Where you obviously belong.
Give us a kiss.
Look, mister, we pay for our seats too, you know.
I travel on this train regularly, twice a week.
Knock it off, Paul. You can't win with his sword. After all, it's his train, isn't it, mister?
And don't take that turn with me, young man. I fought the war for your sort.
I bet you saw you won.
I shall call the guard.
Ah, but what? They don't take kindly to insults, you know. Come on, let's go and have some coffee and leave the kennel to Lassie.
Hey, mister, can we have our ball back?
But, mister!
Drop ball!
Mister!
Keep going!
We have our ball back!
Hey!
Please, mister! Hold on!
You want to watch it?
Well, it's not my fault.
You stick to that story, son.
I can't help it. I'm just taller than you are.
They always say that.
Well, I've got my eye on you.
I'm sorry, Norm. I can't help being taller than you.
Well, don't rub it in. I've a good mind to thump you, Shake.
Hey, if you're going to have a Barney, can I hold your coat?
He started it.
I did, not you did.
Well, what happened?
The old fella said that could he have these pictures, and Norm said no, and all I said was, well, why not be big about it?
And?
Your grandfather pointed out that Shake was always being taller than me just to spite me.
I knew it. He started it. I should have known.
Do you what?
You two have never had an argument in your life. And in 2 minutes flat, he's got you at it. He's a king mixer.
He hates group unity, so he gets everyone at it.
Well, I suggest you just give him the photos and have done with it.
Oh, all right, show devil. Here you are.
Hey, Paulie, would you ever sign one of them for us?
Come ahead, Shake.
Hey, look at the talent. Let's give him a pull.
Should I?
Aye, but don't rush. None of your five-bar gate jumps and over sort of stuff.
What's that supposed to mean?
I don't know. I thought it just sounded distinguished like.
George Harrison, the scars of distinction.
Excuse me, madam. Excuse me, but these young men I'm sitting with wondered if two of us could come over and join you.
I'd ask you myself, only I'm shy.
I'm sorry, miss. You mustn't fraternize with me prisoners.
Prisoners?
Convict in transit. Typical old lads, the lot of them.
You are.
You are.
Get out, ladies! Get out while you can!
He's been gone a long time.
Who?
Paul's grandfather.
Oh, I didn't notice. Where'd he go?
Down the,
Oh, we'll give him a couple of minutes then.
Have you seen Paul's grandfather?
Of course, he's concealed about my person.
Now, he must have slipped off somewhere.
Have you lost him?
Now, don't exaggerate.
You've lost him!
Look, put it this way, Paulie. He's mislaid him.
Honest, you can't trust you with anything, Norm. If you've lost him, I'll cripple you.
He can't have got far.
Come, Ed, let's look up the sharp end.
What's the matter with you, then?
It's his grandfather. I can tell he doesn't like me. It's because I'm little.
Now, you've got an inferiority complex, you have.
Yeah, I know, that's why I play the drums. It's my active compensatory factor. No, she'll only reject me in the end, and I'll be frustrated.
You never know, you may be lucky this time.
No, I know the psychological pattern. It plays havoc with me drum skins.
Excuse me, have you seen that little old man we were with?
Broken out, ah, the blessed freedom of it all.
Have you got a nail file? These handcuffs are killing me.
I was named, I'm innocent, I don't want to go.
Sorry for disturbing you girls.
I bet you can't guess what I was in for.
Should we go in here?
No, it's probably a honeymoon couple or a company director or something.
Well, I don't care. I'm gonna broaden my outlook.
Congratulate me, boys. I'm engaged.
Oh, no, you're not. Not this time.
And to think my own grandson would have let them put me behind bars.
Don't dramatize. Let's face it, you're lucky to be here. They'd have had their own way, you would have been dropped off already. Well, you've got to admit, you've upset a lot of people.
At least I can keep my eye on you while you're stuck in here.
Shove up.
Odds or evens?
Odds.
Don't worry, son, we'll get you the best lawyer green stamps can buy.
Oh, it's a laugh-a-line with Lennon. Anyway, it's your fault.
Why me?
Why not you?
God, it's depressing in here, isn't it? Funny. They usually reckon dogs more than people in England. You'd expect something more palatial. Let's do something, then.
Like what?
Okay. God, it's the girls.
I'll deal them.
Aye, aye, the Liverpool shuffle.
A few, two, three, three, three. I should have known better with a girl like you that I would love everything that you.
wearing his lucky rings.
All mine.
They don't buy your happiness, my son.
Hey, don't move any of you. They've gone potty out there. The place is surging with girls.
Please, sir, can I have one to surgery, sir, please, sir?
No, you can't. Now, listen, as soon as I tell you, get out through this door here into that big car that's waiting.
Snore.
You do, repeatedly.
Do I snore, John?
Yeah, you're a window rattler, son.
It's just your opinion. Do I snore, Paul?
With a trombone duty like yours, it'd be unnatural if you didn't.
No, Paulie, don't mock the afflicted.
Oh, come off it, it's only a joke.
It may be a joke, but it's his nose. He can't help having a hideous great hooter. And the poor little head trembling under the weight of it.
John, Paul, George, come out. Get at it.
Hello, Ding. Tax have caught up with us at last.
None for me, then. Sorry.
This'll keep you busy.
It's your nose, you know. Fans are funny that way. They take a dislike to things. They'll pick on a nose.
Oh, you pick on your own.
Hey, here.
Where's yours?
No, they're for Ringo.
Must have cost you a fortune in stamps, Ringo.
He comes from a large family.
Well? What's the Circle Club?
The management of Le Cirque Club takes pleasure in requesting the company of Mr. Richard Starkey, that's you, to their gaming rooms, Chemin de Fer, Baccarat and Champagne Buffet.
They want me. It's got round you, a big spender.
Well, you're not going.
Quite right. Invites to gambling dens full of easy money and fast women. Chicken sandwiches and cornets of caviar. Disgusting.
That's mine.
Come out, you lot. Get your pens out.
Why?
It's homework time for you load of college puddings. I want this lot answered tonight.
Yeah. I want to go out.
Now, a brute, no denial.
You couldn't get a pen in your foot, you swine.
Ooh. Chatter on, son, chatter on. A touch of the writer's cramp will soon sort you out. Come, head shake.
Try then.
See ya.
Where are you going, then?
Well, he told us to stay, didn't he?
Come, head.
Couldn't we get a taxi?
No, we
couldn't
get a taxi.
Man.
I'll clear up, sir.
Yeah.
I want to be your man.
Hello, monsieur.
Souffle.
I bet you're a great swimmer.
My turn. Bingo.
Pas bingo, monsieur. Bongo.
I'll take the little darlings anyway. 2 and 1 are 3, carry 1 is 4.
Huit. Et sept.
I can't believe that she would leave me on my own. It's just all right when every night I'm all alone. I've got no time for you right now. Don't bother me. I know I'll never be the same if I don't get her back again. Because I know
close your eyes and I'll kiss you.
We're gonna do them, but
you know. Well, now.
Hey, any of you lot put a man in the cupboard?
Man,
that was suckers. Well, somebody did.
He's right, you know.
There you go.
Hey, what's all this?
Oh, him, he's been lurking.
He looks a right lurker, doesn't he?
You're undressed. Where are your clothes?
Well, the old gentleman. He borrowed them to go gambling at the Cirque.
He's gone to my club, has he?
Yeah, it's all your fault.
What?
Getting invites to gambling clubs and all that. He's probably in the middle of some orgy by now.
Orgy?
Orgy!
You're too old.
Oh, good. Champagne, monsieur.
Oh, yeah. And I'll have some more champagne as well.
Lord John McCartney, millionaire Irish peer. Filthy rich, of course.
I don't know. He looks quite clean to me.
Come here, you lot. Try to act with a bit of decorum. This is a posh place.
We know how to behave. We've had lessons.
I'm sorry, sir. Members and invited guests only.
Aye, well,
Oh, yes.
I'm with them. I'm a Ringo's sister.
Excuse me, have you got a little old man here?
Do you mean old McCartney?
Oh, he's at it again. Look, I'm his grandfather. I mean,
Before
you go, gentlemen, there's a little matter of the bill.
I'll take care of that.
£180?
I beg your pardon.
Guineas.
Your winnings, my lord, £190.
What about me change?
Pilgrim charge.
Oh, well, easy come, easy go. Well?
Good morning, mein Herr. Können Sie noch einen Tee haben? Ah, Sie fühlen sich Engländer. Guten Morgen.
Keep Britain tiny. Oh, go on, George.
Don't be ridiculous.
But you said I could.
Honestly, my mind boggles at the very idea. A grown man and you haven't shaved with a safety razor.
It's not my fault. I come from a long line of electricians.
Well, you're not practicing on me.
All right, then. But show us.
Oh, come on, man.
Oh, man.
Oh, Britannia, Britannia rules the...
Put your tongue away. It looks disgusting hanging there all pink and naked. And one slip of the razor and...
Help me! Headphones! Help me! Help!
Torpedoes again, eh?
Come on, lads, the car waiting to take you to the studio.
Hey, where's John?
In the bath.
All right, Lennon, let's have you. Come on, John, stop larking about.
John. 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 What are you messing around with that boat for? There's a car waiting. Come on.
Ready, John? As soon as we draw, open that door and straight in.
Come on, your press conference.
Where have you been? It's your press conference we're arranging. Get out.
All right, give us a couple of shakes to get out of breath.
Give us a shout when it's over. Hey, I have a suit just like him, you know.
Ringo.
Yeah. I don't like the handkerchief. I always have the handkerchief in my trouser pocket. Oh. You can't blow your nose on it up there, can you, mister?
No, you can't.
I never noticed his nose till about 6 months ago.
And my mother asked me before I left for America if I wanted any sandwiches.
Oh, when I plugged her in, she just blew up.
Tell me, how did you find America?
So I left to Greenland.
Has success changed your life?
Yes.
I'd like to keep Britain tidy.
Are you a mod or a rocker?
No, I'm a mocker.
Oh. Have you any hobbies?
No, actually, we're just good friends.
Do you think these haircuts have come to stay?
Well, this one has, you know. It's stuck on good and proper now.
Frightfully nice.
What would you call that hairstyle you're wearing?
Arthur.
No, actually, we're just good friends.
You're the brown, aren't they?
What do you call that collar?
Oh,
I call her.
Oh, do you often see your father?
No, actually, we're just good friends.
How do you like your girlfriends to dress?
Didn't even get a jam butty, did you?
Anything left?
We've just finished, Paulie. Hey, George, give it to John Henry on that picture.
Hey, look at that!
What's that?
Is that all set down there?
Oh, should we go down and have a go?
Yeah, come on.
Yeah,
there's trees and everything.
There's a lot of fellas for one set.
It's not a tree.
It is. Look, it's a bird. Just passing through, like.
Where are they?
On the stage, down here.
Give me any tea, no. Sally down the street. That's funny, he's eating a burner.
Leave them drums alone.
Oh, surely I could just have a little touch.
You so much as breathe heavy on them and I'm out on strike.
Aren't you being rather arbitrary?
There you go, hiding behind a smoke screen of bourgeois cliches. I don't go messing about with your earphones, do I?
Spoil sport.
Well?
He's very fussy about his drums, you know. They loom large in his legend.
What's up?
Oh, he's sulking again.
I'll show him.
If I fell in love with you, would you promise to be true and help me understand? 'Cause I've been in love before and I found that love was more than just holding hands. If I give my heart to you, I must be sure from the very start that you would love me more than her. If I trust
unsuitable, let's have it out in the open. I can't stand these backstage politics.
Aren't you turning to black and white the situation somewhat?
Well, quite honestly, I wasn't expecting a musical arranger to question my ability picture-wise.
I could listen to him for hours.
What's all this about a musical arranger?
Mr. McCartney, Sr.
Hey, Paulie, they're trying to fob you off with this musical charlatan.
But I gave him the test.
I'm quite happy to be replaced.
He's a typical book passer.
I won an award.
A likely story.
It's on the wall in my office. Hello, Arnold. Everybody happy?
All right. If you don't need them, I'll lock them up in the dressing room.
Please do. I'll not need them for half an hour.
Thank you.
Give me a bottle of milk and some tranquilizers. I see it all now. It's a plot. A plot.
Tranquilizers. Come at you, Nuss. I've got the key.
Come at Bingo. Come on.
Leslie Jackson, I saw your father in the old empire in 1909. If you're as good as him, son, you're all right.
Gear costume. Swap.
Cheeky.
Come out, lads. First order, no messing about. Lennon, put them girls down or I'll tell your mother of you. And stop messing about. Stay in here until that rehearsal. And I'm going to keep you in even after I put the lock in the key and turn it.
We're out!
Can't buy me love. Money can buy me love. I'll give you all I've got to give if you say you love me too. I may not have a lot to give, but what I got, I'll give to you. I don't care too much for money. Money can buy me love.
Sorry we aren't your field, mister.
Not here. Hello, Dickie.
Probably gone to the canteen. Cup of tea, like.
No, that's too easy for Lennon.
He's out there somewhere. Cause in trouble. Just to upset me.
You're imagining it, Norm. You're letting it prey on your mind.
No, this is a battle of nerves between John and me.
John hasn't got any.
What?
Nerves.
No. That's just the trouble. I've toyed with the idea of a ball and chain. It just rattled them at me and in public, too. Sometimes I think he enjoys seeing me suffer.
Hello.
Hello.
Oh, wait a minute. Don't
no, I'm not.
Oh, you are.
I'm not.
Oh, you are. I know you are.
I'm not, no.
You look just like him.
Do I? You're the first one that said that ever.
Yes, you do, look.
No, my eyes are lighter. Okay. All right, Noddy.
Oh,
my nose.
Yes, your nose is very.
Is it?
Well, I would have said so.
Oh, you know him better, though.
I do not. He's only a casual acquaintance.
That's what you say.
What have you heard?
It's all over the place.
Is it? Is it really?
Mm, but I wouldn't have it. I stuck up for you.
I knew I could rely on you.
Thanks.
You don't look like him at all.
She looks more like him than I do.
In 10 minutes' time. 10 minutes now, a full rehearsal.
Now,
there you are.
Oh, sorry, must have made a mistake.
No, you haven't, you're just late.
Oh?
Actually, I think he'll be very pleased with you.
Really?
Yes, you're quite a feather in the cap. Hello? I've got one. Oh, I think so. Yes, he can talk. No, well, I think you ought to see him. Yes, all right. Come on.
Sorry.
You don't see many of these nowadays, do you?
Come on. Simon, will this do?
Well, not bad, Dolly, not really bad. Turn around, Chief Baby.
Oh, yes, he's a definite boss. He'll look good alongside Susan. All right, Sammy Jim, this is all going to be quite painless. Don't breathe on me, Adrian.
I'm terribly sorry, but there seems to be some sort of misunderstanding.
Well, you can come off it with us. You don't have to do all the old adenoidal glottal stop and carry on for our benefit.
I'm afraid I don't understand.
Oh, my God, he's a natural.
Well, I did tell them not to send us real ones.
Well, you ought to know by now, the phonies are much easier to handle. Still, he's a good type. We'd like you to give us your opinion on some clothes for teenagers.
Oh, by all means, I'd be quite prepared for that eventuality.
Well, not your real opinion, naturally. It'll be written out and you'll learn it. Can you read?
Of course I can.
I mean lines, Ducky. Can you handle lines?
Well, I'll have a bash.
Good. Give him whatever it is they drink, a Coca-Rama?
Tom?
Well, at least he's polite. Show him the shirts, Adrian. Now, you'll like these. You'll really dig them, that cab and all the other pimply hyperboles.
I wouldn't be seen dead in them. The dead grotty.
Grotty?
Yeah, grotesque.
Make a note of that word and give it to Susan. It's rather touching, really. Here's this kid trying to give me his utterly valueless opinion when I know for a fact that within a month he'll be suffering from a violent inferiority complex and loss of status because he isn't wearing one of these nasty things. Of course they're grotty, you wretched nit. That's why they were designed, but that's what you'll want.
I won't.
You can be replaced, Chicky Baby.
I don't care.
That pose is out too, Sonny Jim. The new thing is to care passionately and be right wing. Anyway, if you don't cooperate, you won't meet Susan.
And who's this Susan when she's at home?
Only Susan can be, our resident teenager. You'll have to love her. She's your symbol.
Oh, you mean that posh bird who gets everything wrong?
I beg your pardon?
Oh, yeah, the lads frequently sit round the television and watch her for a giggle. In fact, once we all sat down, wrote these letters saying how gear she was and all that rubbish.
She's a trendsetter. It's her profession.
She's a drag, a well-known drag. We turn the sound down on her and say rude things.
Get him out of here.
Have I said something amiss?
Get him out. He's knocking the program's image.
Sorry about the shirt.
Get him out! You don't think he's a new phenomenon, do you?
You mean an early clue to the new direction?
Where's the calendar? Oh, no. It's all right. He's just a troublemaker. The change isn't due for 3 weeks yet. All the same, make a note not to extend Susan's contract. Let's not take any unnecessary chances.
Die dir einst dein Herz erfreut, gib der Feind Getröstung schon, du vergessen.
So I explained to my mother he was a very clean man. She was frightened.
Please,
one here.
No one here? Well, where have they gone?
That's wrong, isn't it? Surely that's wrong. No, not you.
Get him out!
Someone come in. Wait, why?
Stop being taller than me.
It's not my fault.
8 foot 9.
What are you doing here?
Hiding.
You must be soft or something.
Well, we weren't hiding, we were resting. I thought I told you not to stop here.
Well?
When I say stay put, I mean stay put.
Don't cane me, sir. I was led astray.
Oh, shut up, John. They're waiting for you in the studio.
Gee, I'm down to do a bit of work.
Oh, God bless you, Ringo.
Oh, this is the teacher's pet.
Crawler.
Take the class, eh?
I'll lay off. Temper,
well, temper! Will you get a move? I've not waited for you.
Sorry.
I now declare this bridge open.
Where are they? Where are they? Where are they?
They're coming.
Hmm?
They're coming, I promise you.
Ah, yes. Well, if they aren't on this floor in 30 seconds, there'll be trouble. Understand me? Trouble.
Standing about, eh? Some people have it dead easy.
Once you're over 30, you're past it. It's a young man's medium. I just can't stand the pace.
Oh, he's young as that, then?
I was.
Ah, there he goes. Look at him. I bet his wife doesn't know about her. I bet he hasn't even got a wife. Look at his sweater.
Never know. She might have knitted it.
He knitted him.
And stand by. Run through your number and try not to jiggle out of position. Hello? Three, coming to you. Three, coming to you. Three.
We're on three.
Oh, yes. Music.
That's all I do. And if you saw my love, you'd love her too. I love her. She gives me everything and tenderly the kiss my lover.
Really, they don't need any work. We're just powder them off for the shine.
Oh, yes, sir. Norm, would you take them under makeup and
and powder them off. The shine, you know.
Sure.
You blinked.
Come on.
Oh, lads. Hey, grandfather's not talking to me. I think he's got a soul comp.
Must be catching on. He's giving it to Ringo here.
Stop picking on
me. I don't need you to protect me, you know, no. I've got a touch of the swine fever, haven't it?
No, come on, lads, sit down.
This is impossible. We'll never get them all done in time.
Then you have to do us first. It doesn't matter to them whether they're made up or not. By the way, what's that?
My name's Betty.
Do you want a punch of your frog tunic?
No.
John, behave yourself or I'll murder you. Shake, take that wig off. It suits you. Ringo, what are you up to?
Page 5. You always fancied yourself as a guardsman, didn't you?
Oh, that this tutu's solid flesh would melt.
Vap!
Hey, you won't interfere with the basic rugged concept of my personality, will you, madam?
Hey, he's reading the Queen.
That's an in-joke, you know.
Shut down!
It's my considered opinion that you're a bunch of sissies.
You're just jealous.
Leave him alone, Lennon, or I'll tell him all the truth about you.
You wouldn't.
Oh, I would, though.
Look it, I thought I was supposed to be getting a change of scenery, and so far I've been in a train and a room, and a car and a room, and a room and a room. Well, maybe that's all right for a bunch of powdered geegaws like you lot, but I'm feeling decidedly straight-jacketed.
What a clean old man.
Don't pressure, look.
He's sex-obsessed. The older generation leading this country to galloping ruin.
What's a pretty girl like you doing in a place like this?
They're nearly ready for you, lads. Just finishing the band call.
I say, did you go to Harrods? I was there in 58, you know. I can get you on the stage.
Oh, how?
Return right here to the corridor and go past the fireplace. I don't like yours.
Now, but don't leave the theatre. Where are you going, John?
She's going to show me a stamp collection.
So's mine.
But
John, I'm talking to you. Stamp. This final run-through is important, understand? Important.
I want a cup of tea.
Shake. I've got to adjust the decibels on the imbalance knob.
Clever. George. Ringo, look after him, will you?
All right, Norm.
Do I have to raise my voice? All right. Come on, Grandad.
I'm a drummer, not a wet nurse. You know. What's that?
Would you look at him, sitting there with his hooter scraping away at that boog.
Well, what's the matter with that?
Have you no natural resources of your own? Have they even robbed you of that?
Well, you can learn from books.
You can you? Sheep's heads. You could learn more by getting out there and living.
Out where?
Any old where. But not her, little Richard. Oh, no. When you're not pumping them pagan skins, you're tormenting your eyes with that rubbish.
Books are good.
Parading's better.
Parading?
Parading the streets. Trailing your coat. Bowling along. Living.
Well, I am living.
You? Living? When was the last time you gave a girl a pink-edged daisy? When did you last embarrass a Sheila with your cool appraise and stare?
You're a bit old for that sort of chat, aren't you?
Well, at least I've got a backlog of memories. All you've got is that boog.
Oh, stop picking on me, as bad as the rest of them.
Ah, so you are a man after all.
What's that mean?
Do you think I haven't noticed? Do you think I wasn't aware of the drift? And you poor, unfortunate scruff. They've driven you into boogs with our cruel, unnatural treatment, exploiting your good nature.
I don't know.
Ah, sure, that lot's never happy unless they're jeering you. And where'd they be without the steady support of your drumbeat? That's what I'd like to know.
That's right.
And what's it all come to in the end?
Yeah, what's in it for me?
A boog.
Yeah, a blooming boog.
When you could be out there betraying a rich American widow or sipping palm wine in Tahiti before you're too old like me.
Yeah, funny, really. Because I never thought, but being middle-aged and old takes up most of your time, doesn't it?
You're only right. Where you going?
I'm going parading before it's too late.
Hey, Ringo, you know what just happened to me?
No, I don't. You want to stop looking so scornful, it's twisting your face.
Tell him of the story, brother. Hello, here he is, the middle-aged boy wonder.
Hey, I thought you were looking after the old man. Well, he had about half an hour to the final run-through. He can't walk out on us now.
Can't he? He's done it, son.
Hey, you know what happened?
We know.
Your grandfather, he stirred him up.
He hasn't.
Yeah, he filled his head with notions, seemingly.
The old mixer, come on, we'll have to put him right.
Can we have
two dancers
on stage for rehearsal, please?
Split up and look for him.
We've become a limited company.
I'll look in here again.
Thank you.
around chugging bricks about.
Southerner?
Here, mate, that's my hoop. Stop playing with it.
Hoop, that isn't a hoop. It's a lethal weapon. Have you got a license for it?
Oh, don't be so stroppy.
Well, a boy your age rolling hoops at people. How old are you anyway?
11.
I bet you're only 10 and a half.
10 2/3.
There you are, then, and don't be rolling with people.
Oh, you can have it. I'm packing it in. It depresses me.
You are?
You heard? It gets on me wick.
That's lovely talk, that isn't. Why aren't you at school?
I'm a deserter.
Oh, you know?
Yeah, I've blown school out.
Just you?
No, Ginger, Eddie Fallon, and Ding Dong.
Oh, Ding Dong Ballet?
Yeah, that's right. They were supposed to come with us, but they chickened.
Yeah? They're your mates, are they?
Yeah.
What's cop without them, isn't it?
Oh, it's all right.
Yeah, what are they like?
Ginger's mad. He says things all the time. And Eddie's good at spitting and punching.
Yeah, how about Ding Dong?
Oh, he's a big head. He fancies himself. You know, it's all right, though, because he's won the game. Why aren't you at work?
I'm a deserter, too.
Oh. Hey, Charlie! See ya!
Time's up. I'm sorry, boys. I didn't mean it. Honest.
If he says that again, I'll strike him.
Oh, don't worry. The good lads, they'll be back.
Yes, we'll have only 20 minutes to the final run-through.
I meant no harm. I was only trying to encourage little Ringo to enjoy himself.
God knows what you've unleashed on the unsuspecting South. It'll be wine, women, and song all the way with Ringo when he gets the taste for it.
That was fresh this morning. 2 and 9. On your way.
You what?
You heard. On your way. Troublemaker.
Hey, watch it.
Shake.
What?
Worry, will you? Well, that's it. 2 minutes to the final run. They're bound to miss it now.
Murder that Lennon.
Still, we could survive a missed run through as long as
they head up for the show. Oh, you're right there. I mean, it wouldn't do to miss the show, like, would it?
Shut up, cheerful. You don't think?
Now look, don't worry.
They can't do this to me. No. It's all your fault. Oh, yes, it is. If they don't turn up, I wouldn't be in your shoes
and
for all the.
For all the tea in China. No, you're right there. Neither would I.
You dirty traitor.
Well, of course.
Yes, of course.
I know.
Hi, John.
John! Did you want something?
Oh, I could eat the lot of you.
You look great with an apple in your glove.
Do you realize you could have missed the final run through?
Sorry about that.
No, huh? There's only 3 of them.
Oh, we were looking for Ringo, but we realized he must have come back here.
Well, do you realize that we're on the air live in front of an audience in 45 minutes and you're one short?
Control yourself, you spurt. He must be here somewhere.
All right, well, we'll look in the dressing room. Shake?
Yes. The dressing room.
It was my grandfather.
Don't worry about him, Paul. He can look after himself.
I suppose so.
Personally signed and handwritten by your own sweet boys. The chance of a lifetime. Be the envy of your less fortunate sisters. Oh, me foot. When we have...
All right, Mac, break it up, break it up. Move
on.
Hey, what's going on here, right? Move over, move over.
Come on, move along.
Look, why don't you go?
Now, will you just move along?
They'll take you apart if you stand here. Now, come along. There's a good fellow.
You don't have to take this.
Nasty little person, you.
You are. Oh, yeah.
Ringo, Stoner, I've got a show to do. I'm on in a few minutes. You've got to let me go.
I'm Ringo.
Yeah, that's what they all say these days. Look, I don't care who you are. You can say that for the stipendiary. Here you are, Sarge.
All right. What is he?
Yeah, I got a little list here. Wandering abroad, malicious intent, acting in a suspicious manner, conduct liable to cause a breach of the peace. You name it, he's done it.
Oh, a little savage, is he?
Yeah, probably a little aboriginal.
I demand to see my solicitor.
What's his name?
Well, if you're going to get technical about it.
Hello, it's going to be one of those nights, is it? Sit Charlie Peace down over there, will you?
Well, you got me here, so do your worst. Well, be God, I'll take one of you with me. I know your game. It means a toilet room, and then out come the rubber hoses.
Oh, there's a fire, is there?
You ugly great brute. You have sadism stamped all over your bloated British kisser.
Hey?
Well, go on hunger strike. I know you're a caper. The kidney punch and the rabbit clout, the third degree and the size 12 boot ankle tap.
What's he on about?
I'm a soldier of the Republic. You'll need the mahogany truncheon on this bio. A nation once again. A nation once again.
Oh, get Lloyd George over there next to the mechanic and the cloth couple. I'll sort this lot out, will you?
Come on, Dad. Sit down over here.
Ringo, me old scout. So they've grabbed your leg for the iron too, have they?
I'm not exactly a voluntary patient.
Shh, shh. Have they roughed you up yet?
What?
Oh, they're a desperate crew of drippins, and their fists like matured hams for pounding poor defenseless lads like you.
Right, and that's it, eh?
One of us has got to escape. I'll get the boys. Hold on, son, I'll be back for you.
For me?
And if they get you on the floor, watch out for your brisket.
They seem all right to me.
Sure, that's what they want you to think. All coppers are villains.
Would you two like a cup of tea?
You see? Sly villains.
No, thank you, Mr. Sergeant, sir. No, not for me. Please, don't.
So you just brought the old chap out of the crowd for his own good, eh?
Well, he was getting a bit nasty, you see, so we had to bring him in.
Well, he can't stop here. This is the stuff you've been hawking around, isn't it?
That's not. Photographs.
Photographs.
Well, son, it's now or never. All right, you paid assassins. Johnny McCartney will give you a run for your certainty.
Hey, you forgot your photographs.
Only half an hour, and you're on.
Can I say something?
Yes.
It seems highly unlikely we'd be on. Hmm? I mean, the law of averages are against it. I think if you could get the juggler on with a couple more clubs, that'd fill in a bit of time.
You ought to be ashamed of yourself. Go home.
I must see Polly.
Go home then and see him on the telly.
Can you fix him for me?
Yeah. 6 months. Each. In a boss.
Mercenaries.
Where's Ringo?
The police have the poor unfortunate lad in the bridewell.
The police station.
He'll be pulled by now.
Go get him.
We'll get him out. We'll fix him, Rob.
I've only got
20 minutes.
Can't buy me love. Money can buy me love. I'll give you all I've got to give if you say you love me too. I may not have a lot to give, but what I got, I'll give to you. I don't care too much for money. Money can buy me love, and buy me love. Everybody loves me so. Just can't buy. I don't care too much for money. Money can buy me love.
What is all this?
Oh, hold on.
Are you all right now?
Lads, you're back, thank goodness. Where's Ringo?
There he is.
We got him. Great.
You don't know what this means to me. If you hadn't come back, it would have meant the epilogue or the news in Welsh for life.
Hey, aren't you supposed to be in that box?
Yeah, it was the old mixer.
Here, Paulie.
Got a few words to say to you, two-faced John McCartney.
I'll leave him alone. He's back, isn't he? It's not his fault he's old.
It's all got to do with it. He's a troublemaker and a mixer. That's good enough for me.
You're right, but he's only asking for attention, aren't you? You see, you know your trouble. You should have gone west to America. You would have been a senior citizen of Boston. You took a wrong turn in. What happened? You're a lonely old man from Liverpool. But I'm clean. Are you?
Hey, no.
What?
I've been thinking. It's not my fault.
What is it?
I'm not taller than you are. You're smaller than I am.
Anyone at all?
Hey, shake, where's me boot? Well, you get us some tea while you're there.
I know, John.
Now, come on, lads, get changed.
Come on, get some tea put on in a minute.
Want to cheese boxy, Paul?
The officers have been on the phone. They think it's best if we push on to Wolverhampton straight away.
Tonight?
Well, you've got a midnight matinee.
I know.
Now, there's only one thing I'm going to say to you, John Lennon.
What?
You're a swine. It's been a hard...